For more than 37 years, Nancy Anthony has been the executive director and president of the Oklahoma City Community Foundation. And for 37 years, she was one of the first ones to make the coffee in the morning and almost always the last one to leave in the evening. Nancy Anthony's accomplishments are everywhere you look in Oklahoma City. Whether it's through an after-school program for children, meals being served to homebound senior citizens, or somebody enjoying one of our many city and neighborhood parks. Nancy more than likely had a hand in all of it. The reality is that Nancy has made so much possible for countless people throughout our community. Under her watchful eye and leadership, the Oklahoma City Community Foundation has made Oklahoma City a better place for all of us.
I really didn't know what a community foundation was. I found out later that most people didn't know what a community foundation was, which was probably a good thing. So it just was a good match for where I was at that point in my life and gave me a chance to maybe to make it up or to be an entrepreneur in some ways.
The year was 1985 when Nancy Anthony was hired to be the executive director at the Oklahoma City Community Foundation. The Board of Trustees, President Dan Hogan, saw something special in her. After all, she was very involved throughout the community with the Metropolitan Library Commission and several other charitable organizations. Dan not only had the support of the other trustees, but also had the support of John Kirkpatrick himself when she was offered the position as executive director. Shortly after she was on board, Nancy was told by founder Johnny Kirkpatrick, "Money is like manure. You don't want to put too much of it in one spot, it'll start to smell. But if you spread it around, it'll do some good."
Bob married Nancy and introduced her to my granddad, and I can only imagine how excited he must have been to meet Nancy. Bright, fun, interesting, interested, and Nancy is a total math whiz, and so is my granddad. I have no idea what the hiring process was like, but over a period of time, Nancy and I have worked together a lot. There's never been a moment that Nancy has ever asked me to help her in any way. It has always been a situation where Nancy has asked me how she can help me with our family's legacy and our family's philanthropy. It is so touching because nobody else is that way. It is remarkable.
If you look around Oklahoma City today, you will see the benefits of all the initiatives Nancy Anthony started for the betterment of the community. Trustee George Records remembers when she was hired. And like the other trustees, he was positive they made the right decision.
Nancy had the best understanding of the objective of the Community Foundation of anyone there. John Kirkpatrick recognized that feature about Nancy early on and kept pushing more responsibility on her.
A year after Nancy became executive director, she felt like the Community Foundation needed some help in the accounting area, and she hired Carla Pickrell. Together, these two trailblazing women set off to make great things happen in Oklahoma City and beyond. As Oklahoma was on the cusp of celebrating its centennial, the Community Foundation marked its 20th anniversary with a series of grants supporting several centennial projects, including a historical map of the 1889 land run. 2 years after Nancy took over the reins at the foundation, the first affiliated fund was established by the William E. Davis family, with gifts totaling just over $1 million. At that time, the Davis family thought the affiliated fund was an attractive alternative to a private foundation for their family.
OCCF was at a takeoff level, and she was determined to have it ready to step up to that next level. I also would say that Nancy Anthony, I think, has shown outstanding leadership in her determination to make the Oklahoma City Community Foundation the very best that it can possibly be.
By 1989, the foundation had been in their new location, which was 115 Park Avenue, for 2 years. And while they were at this address in downtown Oklahoma City, the organization continued to experience new growth.
The Kerr Foundation gave us an opportunity to give us that building, so it was just a perfect match to give us a place to go and yet gave us a visibility, you know, on Park Avenue.
In 1991, school teacher Margaret Annis Boyce left a $1.5 million gift to create a permanent endowment to beautify public parks and lands throughout the city. That single gift was the catalyst for the Parks and Public Space Initiative. And more than 30 years later, we all continue to see the benefits of her gift. And it was at this time, the charitable organization endowment investment and distribution policy was formalized. Ed Barth was a trustee, and he remembers how important it was to have this policy in place and what it would mean to the charitable organizations for years to come.
Throughout Nancy's tenure, the funds have always been the largest number of endowment funds of any community foundation in the country. And it's doubled since I was involved in the board of trustees.
Nancy believed that it was important to take an initiative like this and grow its importance within the community. John Kirkpatrick always believed in the power of endowment and the role it could play for the sustainability of so many nonprofit organizations in the area. He felt so strong about them that 10 years earlier, he decided he would match endowments dollar for dollar for those charitable organizations that established endowments. In 1995, Oklahoma City changed forever with the bombing of the Murrah Federal Building on April 19th. Stepping up and doing her part, Nancy Anthony helped establish the Oklahoma City Disaster Relief Fund and Survivors Education Fund to assist with long-term needs of those impacted by the bombing. At that time, Nancy Anthony knew the foundation had to do something and had a role to play in the lives of those affected by the bombing. Nancy Coates serves as one of the fund trustees during this time.
A part of the disaster relief money was establishing scholarships for the students, the children who had lost a parent. And so the Community Foundation, under the leadership of Nancy Anthony, consolidated those funds in partnership with the Red Cross.
So that turned out to be our single biggest contribution was the scholarship fund. But we were very engaged in the initial disaster relief efforts.
The scholarship department found itself in need of someone who could come in and manage this initiative. And Anna Faye Rose was hired as the foundation's first full-time scholarship coordinator.
She wanted my opinion because I was a licensed social worker. Nancy wanted to know what I thought they could do with a program to help the families and survivors of the bombing.
The expansion of the scholarship program continued as the Trustee Scholarship Initiative was started just 3 years later with the goal of helping more students living in central Oklahoma attend college.
We have actually provided scholarships around a little 10,000 plus students, and then the dollar amount is a little over $23 million in scholarship funding.
At the same time, the foundation expanded its reach into rural Oklahoma when Carolyn Watson, who was CEO of the Shamrock Bank, established the Carolyn Watson Rural Oklahoma Community Foundation to support rural classrooms and communities. And in 1999, a group of Lawton residents transferred assets from the Lawton Retail Merchants Association to create the Lawton Community Foundation.
The Lawton Foundation really was the Lawton Retailers Association earlier on, and they had the expertise of knowing what was needed in the city of Lawton. So it became kind of a model for us for other communities.
And after 31 years, the Oklahoma City Community Foundation named Jeanette Gamba as the first female president of the Board of Trustees.
Of course, Bill Johnstone, you know, had the world's greatest line. He said, well, it's about time that a short Italian-American chair the board.
Jeanette was also instrumental in helping the foundation bolster its image in the community by helping the foundations create their first marketing campaign back in 2004.
We had to have a broader base. More people had to know about the Community Foundation. So we created a campaign that focused on examples in the community, good things that were happening. The link was the Community Foundation. The Community Foundation was helping these donors help the community.
As the Community Foundation continued to grow, Nancy, the staff, and the board felt it was time to move into a new office space. So in 2006, ground was broken at the corner of 10th and Broadway for the new Oklahoma City Community Foundation. The land was owned at the time by Kerr McGee, so trustee Bill Shadid worked tirelessly with Kerr McGee's CEO, Luke Corbett, to purchase the land for the foundation. His efforts worked, and this was the first new office construction along Automobile Alley in four decades. The new OCCF building began the transformation of Automobile Alley, and today it thrives with businesses of all kind, large and small.
If you go to the towers in downtown, the parking's a little more cumbersome. The Automobile Alley is accessible.
We've taken this hard corner at 10th and Broadway and really made a statement about what we want to permeate through our community. And to move from the little building three blocks away to be this anchor.
By 2007, the staff was able to move into their new offices, a 14,000 square foot building that offered plenty of public meeting space for nonprofits throughout the community. Always thinking about her community, Nancy Anthony went on to develop a new concept called iFunds at the foundation. The purpose of the iFunds was to use dollars to preserve a donor's intent while meeting current community needs. The foundation focused on three areas that included opportunities for children, access to healthcare, and services for the elderly.
So under these broad parameters, we could find ways for those donors to benefit the organizations they wanted to serve. And they at first were a default alternative and then later became a go-to alternative for some donors.
In 2012, Oklahoma City was ranked as the seventh most charitable city in the nation. At that time, residents in the metro area donated nearly 6% of their income to charity. When an individual donor contributes to their favorite charity, it meant the donor's passions and interests aligned with that of the particular organization's mission. The Community Foundation launched the GiveSmart OKC platform that same year. This was and continues to be an online platform that gives viewers in-depth information on the charitable organizations serving Central Oklahoma.
It's not only important for the donors, but it's also important for people who want to make donations. And you can look at the GiveSmart profile of all the different entities, and you can make decisions based upon what your own personal interest is.
An area that has always been close to Nancy is her love of the arts. The foundation's longtime general counsel, John Belt, passed away in 2013. John not only took care of legal matters for the foundation, he and wife Joy were good friends to the Anthonys, and they were truly responsible for establishing the Arts District in Paseo. And in 2015, a permanent sculpture in his honor was commissioned and installed in the Paseo Arts District.
And I think the Community Foundation was intriguing to him because of what a difference it makes in the community. Because when I think of the Community Foundation, I feel like it's an organization that empowers. And I think it empowers donors. I think it empowers recipients. And I think in turn, it empowers the community.
By 2017, the foundation had reached $1 billion in assets. And as they continued to grow, so did their headquarters. And in 2018, it was decided to double the size with a new addition, which included even more meeting space for the community.
When we reached the $1 billion level, maybe in the last couple of years, I was wondering sort of what would my granddad say? And he would say that this is fantastic, in that the dream that he had, that came out of this idea, has not only come to fruition, but it has really succeeded.
As Nancy was busy growing the organization, she knew the OCCF was coming up on its 50th anniversary. So with the help of the trustees and the staff, they kicked off their 50th with a year-long list of events that were planned to give back to the community. the OCCF developed the Great Idea Challenge. The team at the foundation sought out ideas from community members that were innovative and inspiring on how they could impact the community for the next 50 years. In January 2019, the foundation awarded a total of $1 million to six amazing ideas that would touch the lives and improve quality of life for thousands of people in central Oklahoma.
These projects were important because they had the potential to touch numerous people in the community. They were very diverse, and they would impact Oklahoma City and central Oklahoma over the next 50 years.
One of the other initiatives the foundation created was a very ambitious tree planting project. Continuing to beautify our city, 800 trees were planted along the Oklahoma River. In a few years, these trees would only attract more and more outdoor enthusiasts who enjoy walking or riding bikes along the river.
So Nancy was very hands-on. We would have areas where we would bring different projects up and we would talk about the project and then how we were actually going to make them come full circle and actually be implemented.
In 2020, our world changed forever due to the global coronavirus pandemic. But one thing never changed, and that was Nancy Anthony's tireless efforts to reach out and help those affected by this horrific pandemic, the most vulnerable population. Together with the four not-for-profit hospitals, Nancy helped to facilitate and create COHIT, which was the Central Oklahoma Community Health Impact Team. The mission was to repurpose two facilities for homeless people who had contracted COVID, but needed a place to isolate before being allowed back into their actual shelter.
The pandemic wasn't more difficult than other storms that we have faced together along the way, some of which were specific to us as opposed to applying to society as a whole.
As the country began to feel the exhaustion of the ongoing pandemic, Nancy felt like the city needed a glimpse of what hope looked like. To brighten up people's lives, she decided to give away 65,000 daffodil bulbs to various groups who would plant them all around the city. And if the virus were not enough, Oklahoma City experienced a 1-2 weather punch with a devastating ice storm and two solid weeks of sub-zero weather that crippled and destroyed millions of trees, shrubs, and plants. Nancy again stepped up and Project Relief was established. Neighborhood associations received 400 new trees to plant to replace some lost in the storm.
I think that was pretty exciting for the Community Foundation to replace a lot of those trees. Said, hey, we're providing these at no cost. I thought that was another valuable thing that we did for the community.
A thinker, a visionary, a leader, a friend. Nancy Anthony, thank you for your tireless efforts in continuing to make Oklahoma City a better place. The Oklahoma City Community Foundation will be forever remembered for the role you played in establishing so many wonderful initiatives that have improved the lives of countless Oklahoma residents. Wherever we look, we will always see Nancy Anthony's touch throughout the community. As she decides what her next move will be, she would encourage all of you to keep going and never stop. Because in her words, only the dead have done enough.
You for your time, your dedication, your intelligence, your candor, your judgment, and everything else you've done to make this a better place for all of us.
I am honored to call you my friend.
Nancy, I just want to thank you for giving me the opportunity to work with you over the last 24 years.
I want you to enjoy your retirement. I think you've really earned it.
I know you're not going to stop working, so if there's anything we can collaborate on together, you let me know, because I'd be happy to partner with you in anything you may choose to do.
Nancy, really well done. An excellent job.
Well, Nancy, I love you, and I thank you. And I'm so appreciative of what you've done for me, what you've done for our family, the way you've handled my granddad's legacy, and the future you've built for Oklahoma City. It's been absolutely terrific.
Nancy, you've made a difference.
And I just want to thank you for being my boss and my friend.